Hey guys, it is Miss Sim Reno. If you are returning to the channel, welcome back. And if you are brand new, I am very excited that you decided to join me here today for another speed build. And as you can see, we are already kind of into it. I definitely have been having an issue lately where I am forgetting to press the record button. I'm not even gonna lie to you. It's going to show up actually in a build coming next week as well, because I just did the voiceover and I realized that I forgot to film part of the build. So that is the only part that is missing from this build, was really just the very beginning. But as you can see, we are building a little cabin here, and I switched the season over to winter. I waited for it to snow, and I was actually building in live mode. Some people call it live mode. Is it live or live? I don't actually know, but I decided to do it in that mode because I actually used the tool mod. When I say a fair amount, I just mean more than I ever have in my entire life. The tool mod is really, really amazing. It is by Twisted Mexi, and I used it specifically to rotate some objects and raise them up to different levels, which I would not be able to do without a mod like this. And you can probably actually already tell at the front of this build, there are some details on the roofing pieces to kind of make it look a little bit more like a craftsman home. And I basically use these chunks of wood that were in the debug menu, and I did all of the tool modding off camera, because let me tell you, it was very embarrassing to have spent, I think, 3 hours to put those roofing details on those three individual roofs in the front of this build. I didn't do it on the back because honestly it took so long, but as you can see, they're kind of right there in the front. So I used 4 different pieces to kind of make those details. And right now I'm actually in the debug menu pulling out these kind of like column boxes. That's definitely not a good explanation, but basically I put them at the bottom of columns to make my own custom looking craftsman columns compared to the ones that we got with the seasons pack. And landscaping for this was actually so, so easy. I'm horrified to see what it looks like when I actually get rid of the snow, if I ever look at this build without snow, because yeah, landscaping is really easy when it's snowy, because one, things usually don't even show up, and two, you get like dead trees and stuff, so they are what they are. And I think I just added like a couple hydrangea bushes, which will look probably a little bit awkward once the snow goes away. But in my opinion, with the snow actually falling, it looks fantastic. I even tried to put terrain paint, which I know won't matter at all with the snow, but I did it anyway. And in the front here, there's actually going to be a little fire pit, not like a bonfire pit, but an actual just a campfire, so your Sims could sit outside and roast marshmallows or s'mores if they really wanted to. And I was a little bit uncertain with the direction that I wanted to take for this build, because I'm starting to open up to doing more snowy builds, some more Christmas inspired builds, or really just winter inspired builds. And originally I wanted this to kind of be like a Christmas cabin. However, I ended up gravitating really quickly towards just making it a family home that happened to be a craftsman kind of like log cabin, which to me just screams winter. So that's pretty much what we ended up with. And right here I am using the new platforming tool that we just got with the update yesterday. Also, if you haven't realized, this is a little bit odd for me to upload on a Thursday instead of a Friday, but with Snowy Escape coming out on Friday, I know I'm gonna have at least like a build or two for either like Friday or over the weekend and stuff. So it's gonna be a little off from my usual schedule, but yeah, we got the platforming ability in the update yesterday and I was so excited to start trying it out. Granted, I have kind of made faux sunken rooms before, but now that we have the ability to do it so easily without having to like trick the game, I am just so thrilled. So I basically made a sunken living room, and in the child's room that I work on a bit later in this build, I actually created a small platform near the 2 windows towards the front of the room, and that's kind of like a little hangout study area, and I just thought it was so freaking cute. I love the platforming. I have been very, very lucky, knock on wood. My game has not been crashing. It has not been glitching. I have not had any issues with the platforms. I know that some people are experiencing their game crashing like multiple times in a play session, and there's just been other glitches and stuff like that. So I don't really know what's happening, but I hope that it's resolved soon, because they did a phenomenal job. I mean, they did fix a ton of glitches. I was looking at the patch notes and I was just like, oh my God, they fixed everything. Like, thank you so, so much. But yeah, some people are having some trouble. So if you are, I hope that they fix it soon. But I have been very, very lucky so far to not experience it. And I really, really hope that doesn't jinx me. But if it does, oh well. But I'm first working on the sunken living room. And like I said, I do use the tool mod a little bit more in this build. So what I did is I actually created some floating shelves. Is that what they would be considered? But I don't know. But I put some shelves above one of the couches, which actually, on second thought, I kind of eliminate this entire living room at first, at least the decorations, because I just wasn't liking how it came together. But I found a setup that I thought really complemented the room and kind of the vibe I was going for. And it's above this little bench. I end up putting a couple of shelves and I put a photo up there that is, you know, just a photo. It's like a wall hanging. It's a painting. And with those, obviously, they clip to the wall. And I sometimes put them on top of shelves like that to make them look as though they're just leaning. But what you're able to do with the tool mod is you're actually able to rotate paintings and kind of make them look as though they are leaning. So you'll see me do it here. I was changing up the axis and I started to tilt the painting a bit. However, I realized that since it was clipped to the wall, it started to tilt into the wall, like it was kind of disappearing. So I removed the wall, replaced the painting, and then just kept going like just one by one, like 1 degree by 1 degree, trying to tilt it. And it just adds that bit of realism for me. Like, it's just a touch, but I thought it looked so good. And I end up doing the same thing in the child's room as well with some paintings on some shelves. So that's something that I tried to do in multiple areas throughout this build. And something I actually noticed with using the platforms now, and I realized this when I made my own kind of sunken rooms too, is the wall height ends up seeming a lot taller, and therefore I struggle to sometimes decorate the walls. This is totally a me problem. This has nothing to do with the update. Like, the update for me has been so smooth, and like I said, the platforms have worked perfectly, but yeah, it's totally weird. Like, that mirror was hanging so high up on the wall too, since the walls did seem higher with it being a sunken room. So I did have to remove the wall and kind of like use the move objects cheat to raise it up just to where I wanted it and kind of figure that out. But the living room is pretty much settled at this point. And now we move on to the kitchen, which I admit is weird. You don't have to tell me it's weird. I know it's weird. I know it is a weird kitchen because this is basically like the kitchen and dining room. I did playtest this build and everything is accessible, but yeah, there's only 3 seats and it's just such a small, like, lanky room. Lanky is not the word. It is a long room and it's just a little bit weird considering how quote-unquote big this house is. The kitchen and dining room being combined like this in such a long and narrow space is honestly weird, but I just went for it because I knew I wanted to make it at least a 2-bedroom. That was kind of my issue, is the upstairs, there is kind of a attic space, or at least a space that you could turn into an attic, but it just wasn't wide enough for it to be a bedroom, so I couldn't make it that functional, and therefore I wanted to ensure that there were at least 2 bedrooms downstairs. And with that, I didn't really have any options, so this ends up being the kitchen and dining room. But now I am decorating and cluttering up the kitchen. I put a shelf over this really nice bright orange stove that I haven't used in a long time, at least in that swatch. I think I used this stove literally in a build yesterday, but I haven't used that swatch in a while, and I thought it actually kind of sort of complemented, I won't say match, but I think it complemented this tiled wallpaper, this tile from Realm of Magic, and I noticed that it has almost like little birds on it. At least that's what it seems like. So I ended up putting a piece of artwork over the dining room table that had birds as well, just to kind of, you know, have it all tied together. And then I just added some sconces, and yeah, that's pretty much it for the kitchen and the dining room. So I end up actually moving on to the child's room, and this is where I do the little platform. It seems like it might be too small of a space to do this, but it worked perfectly. I end up putting a bed up against this wall here, and like I said, up here on the platform is like a little hangout slash desk area, so this child could do their homework, and the dresser right here, fully functional, even though it looks a little cramped up against the platform in the bed. I was just so thrilled, and I love just adding, it's such a small accent to this, like it's such a small part of this room using the platforms in this way. I didn't use them in very extravagant ways, as you can tell, but I just loved being able to use them. It just adds a little bit more dimension and personality to the room and the design, I suppose. So I really, really enjoyed it, and I hope you guys like it. even though it is a very minor use of the new ability, but we are continuing to decorate this room here, and I was thinking that this Sim just loved purple and pink, and now I don't know if this is their son or their daughter or anything. It really doesn't matter what child Sim you have in here. All I know is that they love those colors. And I give them a little poof over there in the corner, so maybe that's where they read, or I would imagine like write in a journal or like talk on their phone or something like that. Granted, our Sims cannot write in their journals, I don't think, just sitting in a chair. I think they do need a desk. And here is where I use the tool mod once again to tilt this painting up against the wall to make it look like it's leaning on these shelves. And like I said, it's so small, but I think it's, I don't know, it adds a lot of personality as well. Same with the platforms, it adds personality and I think it's really cool. And then I just add a little nightlight here and then toss down some rugs, and I actually paint the room pink as well just to have the room tie together a little bit more. And you'll also see in one of the screenshots, there's like this plank of wood sticking into one of the poofs. And that was one of my mishaps with the tool mod, trying to make those little roof accents. And yet when I went back to it to delete it in build mode, it was gone. So I don't really know what was happening. Also, the painting that I kind of half put on this wall here tilting was also gone at one point. And then when I went into like tab mode, literally pressing tab to go look around, like take screenshots, it reappeared. So I don't really know what was happening. Maybe I am experiencing some glitches, but it could also be because I'm using the tool mod and stuff like that. But now I am working on the one and only bathroom. This is the one and only 3-quarter bath, technically, since it doesn't have a bathtub. But considering this family has a child Sim, I didn't think it was going to be a big deal, because with toddlers, you definitely need a bathtub. Otherwise they will be stanky and we don't want that. But the bathroom's not too exciting, and then I just move on to the parents' bedroom, or even the hallways. Actually, I think I wanted to do the hallways first because those are typically a little boring in my opinion. The bedrooms are usually a little bit more exciting to me, so I did work on this hallway, and I just kind of decorated this little console table in the front, and I felt as though that technically it's a shelving unit from Seasons that kind of has like the scarves and the jackets and some of the boots and stuff. Perfect for a mudroom, at least that's what it's called in the US. I think on my British suburban home, someone had noted that it's called something different in the UK, and I can't remember. But yeah, that's like the little mudroom, little entryway area. And I did not go crazy with decorations in the hallway, which I usually try to do because I don't like big, blank, empty spaces. But I didn't clutter up this little kind of like china cabinet here from Seasons. I just put a painting above it. I think I end up just putting another painting over here on this wall. And there's just like one chair in the hallway with a plant and some runner rugs. And I thought it was just enough, so hopefully you guys agree. But now I am working on the parents' room. And initially I was going to use this base game bed that I end up plucking out because I just thought, now let's mix it up a little bit. But as I continued to decorate, it just looked a little bit too, I don't know, it didn't look cozy enough to me. I think the wood tones were pretty warm and welcoming, but I wasn't getting the cozy vibes. And one of the beds that really gives me the cozy vibes is one from Seasons. So once I pulled out the Seasons wardrobe, I was like, all right, fine, I'm using it. It's okay, I use it a lot, but I'm gonna use it again. And I put the dresser over here, I put a mirror above the bed, and then they also have a standing mirror. I end up shuffling the little hampers, I was gonna call them dressers, and they're not, the little hampers over here by the door, and I end up moving the mirror on the other side just so your Sims can actually use it. I place a plant in the corner, and then I put some clutter on top of the wardrobe as well. But the parents' room isn't too exciting. I've been kind of struggling with adult Sim rooms lately, so I'm trying to think of different ways to decorate them, especially in family homes. But once we clutter up this room, we end up moving on to the back porch, where I just place a couple of more benches. And then there is a swing set and a monkey bar set in the backyard as well, just because I didn't know what else to decorate on the outside, considering it was snowing. But that is actually pretty much it for the build. I cannot wait for Snowy Escape tomorrow, and I will catch you guys next time I post a video, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!
Everyone's around to share this holiday. Yes, it's a time of happiness, a time of joy, but now this year is twice as special, cause I'm hoping for us to fall in love in this winter wonderland. Chilling by the fire as I'm trying to get you. stars shine much brighter? Or is it just your eyes?